Hi there, it's Sarah from Inkno, here today with a video all about polling in Microsoft Teams. If you're new here to these EdTech tips, you can go ahead and hit subscribe to stay in the loop. If you're not new here, welcome back. Being able to poll your students and get feedback as soon as possible from all of your students can really help you understand how they're doing on any given topic. Luckily, Microsoft makes this pretty easy to do with Microsoft Forms. So Microsoft Forms is fully integrated into Teams so that you can poll your students either in a channel discussion or during one of your online classes. So first, let me show you how to do this in a channel discussion. So I have my Microsoft Teams opened up here, and to add in a poll, I just need to go down to the bottom and click on these three dots and click on the Forms application. From here, I can make a new question and the answers. When your poll creation is complete, you can choose to share the results automatically after students have submitted and to keep them anonymous. I'll leave it how it is and I can click Save. And it will show you a quick preview of your poll, and so that you can edit it or you can click send to send it out to that channel. So now you'll see that there are two different posts here. One is so that you can click on an option and click submit, and the other one shows the answers of that poll. So students are now able to go in and submit on their own. Another way to get responses from your students using Microsoft Forms is to do it during one of your online classes. So this can help you because you'll be able to receive these responses from your students right away. To have one of these polls in your online class, we have to do a little bit of setup beforehand. So to do this, we can open up our calendar and click on a meeting that you already have scheduled. One thing to note here is that you must have attendees invited to this meeting to add in a poll. So to add in the poll, we're going to go to the plus button at the top and click on Forms, similar to what we did previously. So here, once it is set up, we can create a new poll that we want to ask our students during class. So I'm going to go ahead here and add in a question. And when the question is all complete, you can see there are a couple of similar options down here like previously as well. So you can choose which ones to have, and then you can click Save. And then you will see the poll appears here on screen. So right now it is just a draft. So we can choose to launch it now before meeting begins. If you launch a poll before the meeting begins, students can answer it in the chat feature of Teams. However, we can also just wait until our Teams meeting to ask this question. So I'm going to wait for now. And here you can also edit this if you need to, or delete it if you want to change. And you can add in as many polls as you would like. So now let's get into this meeting and see how it works. So I have the meeting opened up here along with a student that has joined, and you'll notice we have the Forms poll option here on that top toolbar. So when we open that up, you'll see the different drafts of questions that you have created, along with the option to create a new poll if you wish. This makes it so flexible for you and gives you the ability to ask a question on the fly if need be. So let's launch this question and see what it looks like for the students. So you'll notice that a pop-up will come up and you can submit a response if you want. But let's also check out what it is on the student side. So here on the student side, you'll see that they have a chat notification, and when we open that up, they can see the question here. So they can respond and submit their answer and also see the results down here. So remember, if you don't want the results to be shown right away, you can change that in those settings when we created the poll. So let's go back over to the teacher side, and we can close this poll once all of their students have finished up submitting their responses. So on the side here, you can see that you can view the results, close, export, or delete. So let's close this so that nobody can submit anymore. And now I want to export these results. The results will be downloaded as an Excel file onto your desktop so that you can open it up and look at it whenever you need to. However, there's also one other place you can look at these results. So let's close up this meeting. And back in our Teams, if we go into the calendar and click on that meeting we were just in and go up to the poll tab, we can see the results of those polls that we had during our meeting. This is a great way to view the responses that your students have given and keep that data for later. Now, to really upgrade your online classes, and especially if you're looking for a little bit more variety in the questions you're asking your students, you can use ClassPoint. ClassPoint allows you to ask your students more than just a simple multiple choice question like this polling in Teams. And it allows you to use your presentation in PowerPoint without having to leave to go to another application to ask these questions. So if you're interested, check out the video that's linked in the description below. I can tell you all about it. Thanks so much for watching this video. I hope you guys can use this polling in Teams to increase your student engagement for your online classes. Don't forget to give us a thumbs up and hit subscribe. I'll see you guys next time.